enjoy yourself. It's later than you think. The years go by as quickly as a wink. Enjoy yourself, it's later than you think.
Hi, we're back in the kitchen. I always tell people that our recipes that are in the cookbook and the folks that we invite to come on the show are just home cooks, just like everybody else, just home cooking. That's what we do. But every once in a while, we slip in a professional. We have a celebrity who happens to live here in this area, and that's Elsie Henderson. Elsie, it's good to see you again in the kitchen.
Nice to see you.
And
if you hadn't been able to come, I would have called that gentleman who reminds me so much of you.
That's right. I have a double here in town, so everybody's always calling him instead of me. Anyway, Elsie has been here cooking with us before because Elsie has a long background as a professional cook. She cooked for the Kaufamann family when they lived out at Fallingwater, which was a Frank Lloyd Wright building here in western Pennsylvania, and it's actually one of the great architectural treasures of the country and one which we here in this area take advantage of whenever we can. And you, how many years did you cook there, Elsie?
Well, I went there in 47.
Uh-huh.
And they turned the house over to the conservancy in 63.
Uh-huh.
And I was in and out all of 64 because Mr. Kaufamann would call and tell me that he had people coming in that he wanted me to show them through.
Yeah. Oh, so. That's terrific. Well, the recipe that we've selected from the many that you have sent to us over the years is a lamb rosemary chili. Now, I'm going to start this lamb in the pan so we can get it nice and browned. This is just a pound of ground lamb. The Kaufmanns had their own lambs, didn't they?
Oh, yes.
On the property? Well, where?
And every Monday, Mr. Green, the head gardener, would send legs of lamb to different friends of Mr. Kaufmann's. That was standing orders every Monday.
Wow. And did they eat lamb frequently?
Quite often, quite often.
Okay. So this was one of the meals that you would prepare for the family?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right, while that's frying up, I'm going to chop an onion, right?
You want me to watch the meat then?
Okay, well, we'll switch over here.
Change places.
And I'll chop an onion. How fine would you like it?
Well, I think we just put in about half of that.
Half of this? Mm-hmm. Okay. And you want it finely chopped?
Yes.
All right. Do that.
This is a lovely skillet.
Yes, well, and it's non-stick, so you don't have to add any fat in it. The fat from the lamb will render this recipe, so there's no added fat to it. Now, all of the recipes that you've ever sent to us, Elsie, are healthy in their own way because you always use lots of natural ingredients and flavorings.
Yes.
It's not processed. So you didn't use many processed foods out there in the kitchen, did you?
No. Almost everything was grown there, and our vegetables were picked on Fridays.
Uh-huh.
So they would be fresh for the weekend.
Okay. Now I'm going to add these. Now the kitchen that you worked in was obviously part of the house, so it was designed by Frank Lloyd Wright. Was
but
it a good?
It's so small.
It was. He didn't think much of cooks then, huh?
But our chef.
Shall I put this in now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Our chef was a very heavy man, but most of his life he had been a dancer, so he could maneuver in the small kitchen.
Is that right? He had a way of getting around,
yeah.
Huh? Now the main flavoring for this chili is fresh rosemary, and so we have a couple of sprigs of that. Is this again? I'm assuming this is something that they grew on the property. Fresh herbs.
All of our herbs.
Yeah.
All of our herbs.
All right. I'm going to pull this off the stem.
And Mrs. Kaufamann had her own private herb garden off of her bedroom. She liked to grow them.
Mm-hmm. About how much of this do you think you'll need, Elsie?
I think maybe just about, I think that's plenty.
This, that much
yes,
there?
Yes.
Okay. I'll put these aside.
Oh, that smells so good.
Yeah, you can really smell that lamb. That lamb smell. So many times I'm in the supermarket and I will see, you know, they have different ground meats, and I'll see ground pork, ground beef, ground veal, and I know exactly what to do with them. But I, frankly, when I see ground lamb, I pass it right by. I rarely think to use it in recipes like this. But if you adjust the seasonings, it makes perfect sense. Get that stem out of there.
There we go.
So that's lost its pink color, most of it there.
Yes,
and I have
about.
This pretty fine, so that we won't have any big clumps of rosemary in our mouths when we taste it.
And the onions are just right too.
Okay, shall I put this in now?
Yeah.
Start to add the flavoring. All right. Oh boy! As soon as you put that into the hot pan,
it comes right out.
That
of
really
the aroma
comes to life. Oh my goodness. Now, did they have a lot of guests who came to eat, or was it mostly just the family who ate there?
When we had this dish, it was mostly gentlemen.
Oh, yeah? This is the favorite of the male guests?
Yes.
Who came?
And then we would also make it with the red beans, so they had a choice, the red beans or the white beans.
Uh-huh. Well, what else he's talking about is that this recipe calls for white kidney beans, which we in Italian would call cannellini beans. And if you shop in the supermarket, you'll see in the can that it calls them either cannellini beans or white kidney beans. And that's exactly what they are. They're like a nice, big, meaty bean. They're just like a kidney bean, but with
white
skins.
Now, I think this can go down a little.
So we can lower the temperature on this, put it down to medium. And as it goes down to medium,
we're ready to put the...
we're going to put tomato sauce in here?
Yes, I think that can go
in this is. This calls for 1 cup of tomato sauce. So that's 8 ounces. I just... we got one of those small containers. And you'll want to put the other seasonings in, right? What are the... white pepper? Yeah, there's some white pepper. Why did you select white pepper? Is this something special to this dish?
Well, it wouldn't have made much a difference because you can't see either one.
Yeah, but do you think that it has a slightly different flavor?
I think so.
Okay.
I think the black pepper is a bit stronger.
Uh-huh.
I don't know, but I think it is.
Oh, there, that's cooking down nicely. Now,
so
that's sort of like simmering along here. Now, there are some other flavorings that you added to this, which I thought was pretty interesting. Lemon
this
juice?
This is the lemon juice.
You squeezed, as you said, just a teaspoon of lemon
plenty.
Juice. And then you put a teaspoon of sugar in to balance that.
Is that kind of dry?
Oh, just sitting out too long here. Under the lights, everything gets dried out. And I know that when I make my regular Mexican-style chili, I always add a tablespoon of brown sugar and a tablespoon of vinegar. And
oh,
so
the vinegar is taking the place of my lemon juice.
Yes, so I thought that was pretty interesting that that there's that sweet and sour ingredient in this that is similar to some of the chilis. Should we add the beans now?
Now the beans.
Okay. And now this has got to... You stir and simmer this. I'm just checking our ingredients. Elsie, I think we are...
We didn't forget anything.
No, I don't think we forgot a thing. So then this would sit and simmer for, what would you say, 20 minutes or half an hour?
Yeah, about a half an hour.
I'm going to lower this. I actually made some of this before, Elsie, so that we could have take a look at it and have a taste. You know, we always like to have a taste of these things.
Yes, we have to feed the public.
Yes. So let me pull all this stuff out of the way so you can see.
Good.
So this has cooked and it's mellowed and tender and really looks delish. So I'm going to put some out onto a plate I also like this recipe because as you have it, Elsie, this could be doubled, tripled, quadrupled, but it also doesn't make so much that you would have leftovers for 4 years after you make this, you know.
Well, you're not going to have too many leftovers anyhow.
Not today, we're not, no. And you made these beautiful little corn. These are in the shape of fish. Elsie, these are so cute. I can't believe, oh, I'll have to eat this one.
You killed it.
I killed it. I pulled the tail right off that fish. Oh, delicious. Now, let's have
a little. But they were served very hot.
Yes. Okay, so you would make them just before you went to serve.
Yes.
All right, Elsie, it's the moment of truth. I have to have a taste of your chili. Here's Bud.
They'll enjoy it.
Mmm. Elsie, that is delicious. You want to have a taste?
Yes.
Whoop, there's your spoon. You have a spoon. Bite of one of these cornfish.
Little fish.
And while we do this, here's how you can get your copy of America's Home Cooking Healthy Recipes. Thank you, Elsie. That was terrific.